In this example, we're going to write parametric equations to describe the circular path at the tip of a 10-inch second hand of a clock. We're going to assume xy is the position of the tip relative to the origin at the center of the circle. So the first thing that would be helpful in this situation is to know the parametric equations for a circle. So let's start by writing those down. So the most common way that the parametric equations of a circle are written are like this. X equals h plus a cosine of omega t, and y equals k plus a sine of omega t. Now in this representation, the center of the circle is at the point h, k. The radius of the circle is the absolute value of a, and the angular frequency at which the circle is generated is given by omega. Now, you can also switch these, and by that I mean I could write x equals h plus a sine of omega t, and y equals k plus a cosine of omega t. And this would also form a circle. Its orientation would just be opposite than the representation I wrote above. That is, the circles will just be traced out in opposite directions. And so we can use either one of these. In a second, we'll decide which representation is going to be best for our particular situation. But let's first think about the easy things, the center of our circle and the radius of our circle. So what we have here is we have a second hand of a clock. And as you can picture, as the second hand moves around, it traces out a circle. So we're going to take the center of our circle just to be at the origin, the point 0, 0. Now the radius of the circle is just going to be given by the length of the second hand, which in this case we're told is 10 inches. Okay, so those are the easiest things to think about. Next, let's try to think about the angular frequency. Now the angular frequency is the rate at which the circle is traced out. So we can think about the rate that the tip of the second hand is moving. Now angular frequency is typically measured in units of radians per unit time. So we can use those units to help us think about what the value of the angular frequency is going to be. So our second hand is going to move one full circle in 60 seconds, of course, because it's a second hand. Now, one full circle is 2 pi radians. So then our angular frequency is going to be 2 pi radians per 60 seconds. Or we could write that as pi over 30. And the units there would be inverse seconds. So that's our angular frequency. So now we have all the elements we need to fill in our equations, but there's one decision left to make. We need to think about which representation of the circle would best suit our situation here. Now to do that, it might be helpful for us just to sketch out what we hope to get out of our equations. So in other words, okay, here's x and here's y. Now, if we think about the way the second hand of a clock behaves, we usually would consider it to start at this point here, which in my case would be the point 0, 10, since I'm thinking about a radius of 10. So I'd like it to start there, and then I'd like the hand to move in the clockwise direction. So let's try to think about which equations would do that best for us. So let's write down our two options here. H and K are both 0, since our center is the origin, and A is 10. So my options here are x equals 10 cosine of pi over 30t and y equals 10 sine of pi over 30t. Or I could write this as x equals 10 sine of pi over 30t, y equals 10 cosine of pi over 30t. Okay, so let's think about what happens when t equals 0 for each of these representations. So my first representation here, where I've got the cosine in the x and the sine in the y, if I plug in t equals 0, I'm going to get x equals 10 cosine of 0, which is going to be 10 times 1, which is 10. And then I'm going to get y equals 10 times sine of 0, which is going to give me 0. Okay, so at time equals 0, then I have the point 10, 0. Right, so I'm over here. Okay, and then let's think about maybe what happens after 15 seconds. Okay, so t equals 15 seconds. We'll think about that. Well, if I plug in 15 to x here, I'm going to get 10 times cosine of 15 pi over 30, or pi over 2. So it's going to be 10 times 0, which is 0. And then if I plug in t equals 15 to y, I'm going to get 10 times sine of pi over 2, which is 10 times 1, which is 10. Okay, so at 15 seconds, then, I'm at the point x equals 0, y equals 10, so now I'm up here. So this is not good, right? I'm starting in the wrong place, and I'm moving in the counterclockwise direction. So that's not going to work out for us. All right, well, let's see if this other representation works any better. Okay, so let's plug in t equals 0 to this formula. So if I plug in t equals 0, I get x equals 10 times sine of 0, which is 10 times 0, so that's 0. And then y equals 10 times cosine of 0, which is going to be 10 times 1, which is 10. Okay, and then so let's go ahead and do 15 seconds as well while we're at it. 15 seconds is going to give me an x value of 10 sine of pi over 2, which is 10 times 1, or 10. And then my y value would be 10 cosine of pi over 2, which is going to be 10 times 0, or 0. Okay, so what happens if we graph those points? Well, at time equals 0, we're at the point x equals 0, y equals 10, so that's good. I'm starting here. And then at t equals 15 seconds, I'm at the point x equals 10, y equals 0. So here I am here. So that's a good start. And let's just plug in one more point just to make sure we've got this right. Let's see what happens at 60 seconds. We should be all the way back at our starting point since this is a clock. Well, if I plug in 60 to x here, I've got 10 times sine of 2 pi. Okay, so that's going to give me 10 times 0, which is 0. And then for my y value, I'm going to get 10 times cosine of 2 pi. So 10 times 1, which is 10. So we're back to our starting point. So this looks pretty great. This looks like it describes the motion we want correctly. Now we'll just add a little disclaimer here about units. So we'll say where x and y are measured in inches and t in seconds. Now, I'll just mention really quickly that this representation of the circle is not unique. We could have written it in a different way. Instead of controlling the direction by switching the sine and cosine around, we could have also controlled the direction of our motion by changing the sine of omega. So in general, there are going to be different ways to represent the same circle parametrically, but this is one of the ways we could represent the motion of this clock.